So Ben Margera, welcome to Finland.
Thank you. When I found out that he was coming to Finland, I was like, yeah, I'll definitely do the show. Because I did one in Iceland before, and it went really well, so I wanted to come here too.
Yeah, you've been here quite many times before.
Yeah, this is like my 13th time here.
You were supposed to be here, or you're supposed to be here because of the show, Don't Do This at Home, Jackass, but it got cancelled because of Steve-O.
Yeah, Steve-O's in jail right now. Yeah, he's in jail for smuggling drugs. He did it as a joke, like somebody had it, and he had like a bag of hash or whatever, and then he just swallowed it as a joke, and then he told the press in Sweden, he's like, yeah, dude, I fucking swallowed a bag of hash. Next day, the cops were banging on his hotel door and arrested him.
So how many shows do you have to cancel because of this?
This is the only one. We did one in Copenhagen without him. Like, we did the Steve-O show without Steve-O. It was me, Ryan Dunn, and Wee Man, and we just put it together somehow. We winged it so bad. We were kicking people in the nuts, puking on people. I was just doing these skateboard drop-ins. Yeah, we totally wong the whole thing, and it ended up, people ended up liking it, so.
Yeah, you're gonna do a show on MTV, Kiss a Good Bam's Ass, or something like this?
That's what I'm hoping to call it, but, you know, the lawyers might not like that too much, so I might have to start thinking of another name, Kiss a Good Bam's Ass.
What's the show all about?
It's pretty much like, see, I live in this house that I bought, and my parents live there, and, like, so if I own the house, don't I make the rules? Like, it's just so ass backwards, and MTV loves it. They're like, wait a minute, you make the rules at your house that your parents live in? We gotta do a show about this.
You started with the CKY shows some back in the days, long time ago. How did the whole thing start?
I turned pro for skateboarding, and then I made this, like, funny video, and then, I got like proper distribution. Spike Jonze and Jeff Tremaine saw it from MTV or whatever, and they're like, "All right, well, we want to use some of your footage from CKY1 and make a pilot." I was like, "All right, do whatever, you know." And then they're like, "All right, it's going on the air. We're gonna have a show on MTV." I'm like, "What? No way!" And then like all of a sudden it's on TV and everybody's like freaking out about it.
But what about you're having some new movie coming out, Haggard or something like this?
Yeah.
What's that about? all things are new things. You just have a lot of things going on all the time.
Yeah, Haggard is basically I spent $100,000 and I bought a movie camera, and Ryan Dunn's life is so pathetic that I just had to make a movie about it. His girlfriend was cheating on him with the whole town of Westchester behind his back, and like once he found out about it and everything went down, I'm like, dude, this is the greatest, like, this is so entertaining, I'm making a movie about it. It's called Haggard, and pretty much every song in there is from him.
Oh yeah?
Finnish band, him.
You're a very big fan of him, and you made two videos.
Yeah.
Also.
Yeah, Buried Alive by Love we did in LA, and we got Juliet Lewis in that, so that's like, I was really psyched about that. I guess BMG Finland liked the video so much that they flew me out to Prague for round two to film The Sacrament. We just wanted to get like some like gothic looking churches or like just Victorian looking like mansions and stuff like that. We went to this modeling agency, got a chick, and this girl's just walking around alone, and then she looks at a photo, and like Villa fades into the picture, and then at the end of the video he fades out, so. It's I don't know. Franzi Boy explains it better than me. He's the producer.
Okay.
We found the best location outside of Prague. It was this mansion called Litomir's, and it had everything. It had a huge backyard, a balcony, a grand piano for Burton's intro, the sketchy-looking basement, a perfect spot for the band's performance, and loads of peacocks to drive me nuts. We did find a girl. And we were meeting with her the next day.
Here, take that. Yeah.
Where are we going?
We're going, okay, right now we're going to the modeling agency.
As soon as we saw Vanda, we realized that she was the perfect biatch for the video. And then we tried to talk to her, and we realized that she doesn't know a lick of English. Like, she didn't know any English at all.
But hey, that's why we got a translator, right?
Okay, it's the first day of the shoot. Right when we get there, there's a f***ing wedding. And not only was there a wedding, like, they could have been out in the park or whatever, but they were, like, playing music and shit. Like,
I can't take this shit. Money's at stake here, and there's a f***ing wedding going on. Fuck this.
You know, me and Bam really like to shoot 35 because you just can't beat it. Anyone else will tell you, you know, digital look. Oh, digital looks just the same,
digital,
man.
You can stop!
That's going to be empty tonight.
Aight?
That's going to be empty tonight. It's going to be empty in 5 minutes.
But what makes Villa Valo so special?
I don't know. When I came out here in May 2000 for the pro skate contest, Razorblade Romance just came out, and I was like, what is going on? Why is there so many ads about Razorblade Romance? So I bought the album, and then I listened to it, and I liked every song on there, like, exactly the same amount, which never happens. So I was like, all right, this is my favorite band. and then I started to fly out to their shows to see them live, and I just eventually became friends with all of them.
You have some same tattoo as Villa. Can you show me that?
Yeah, I actually have a new one that he said that he wants to get on his ribs, too. Yeah, the guy who does all him's artwork, he drew this for me. That one, too.
Okay. We thought about all the other guys, including Wee Man and some of the others, are staying at the hotel over there, on the other side of that. Thought about going over there. It's okay to see the other ones and talk a little bit more about Jackass and so on.
We could do that, but I'm just letting you know ahead of time that it could be very bad news. If they're not already kicked out of the bar, then as soon as we get there, there's going to be some broken chairs because the manager, out of all people, who is supposed to, like, keep things together, he just drank 23 Jack and Cokes. 23. It's 6 o'clock now. He's out of his mind. He's out of his gourd. He was trying to, like, pickpocket. Ah, never mind. Like, when you're ordering 3 drinks at a time, and then as soon as they come, you just break them in front of the bartender, and he doesn't kick you out, like, what can you do next? Like, how are you going to get kicked out? Because, like, he's just going to keep trying to do crazier things to just, because the camera's rolling. Look, I have airport socks on. There's puke on my shoes. Still hungover from 3 days ago. I never smoked weed in my entire life, but for some reason I decided to eat, like, a quarter pound of it. So out of my mind.
Jackass and all the films made you, I can guess you're quite a big star in USA. How has it changed your life?
Now, instead of signing, like, 20 autographs, I'll sign 30 that day instead, you know? Like, the only difference is now I have a little bit more money to spend for fun time at the bar. or just, like, I don't know, any kind of movie camera equipment, I'll just buy it, you know? Uh-oh, I think Dunlap got thrown out. Oh, no, Wee Man's there, though.